Let's start with lesson 2, Tom Meets the Water Babies,
which is an adapted story from the novel called The Water Babies. Okay, children, what is novel? Novel means a big story. This novel is a fairy tale for a land baby, which means the author has written this fairy tale, this novel, okay, especially for a land baby. Who is a land baby? Yes, it's you. You all are land babies. Yes, that is human baby. Okay. And it is a novel especially for children. Children, this is the picture of Charles Kingsley, who is the author of the novel The Water Babies. Now, before entering into the prose, let's know about him. Charles Kingsley was born in England. He lived during the period 1819 to 1875. He did many things through his life, like teaching history, writing novels and poems. He was also a priest. Children, priest means religious leader who does the rituals with a pure heart. He cared deeply about nature, the rights of humans, the environment, and cleanliness. Now, all these causes are seen in his novel, The Water Babies. Okay, now I think you know what is the outline of the novel, The Water Babies. The content, okay, what he has written in The Water Babies is all about nature, the rights of humans, the environment, and cleanliness. Shall we start with the synonym? Water babies are the creatures that look like human babies, exactly like you, but they live in water. Chimney sweep. A person whose job is to clean the inside of chimneys. Children, if you have not seen chimney, I have displayed a picture. Yes, I have highlighted it. So that is chimney. You can see these kind of chimneys in the village houses. Delightful means lovely. Now let us start with the prerequisite knowledge. I want you all to look at the four pictures which is given under start here. Now put your finger as I read. Rivers are a very important source of fresh water. So which is a very important source for the fresh water? Rivers. Yes. So that's why we have to keep the rivers clean. Children, what is fresh water? The water which we can drink. The sea water and ocean water are salty, which we can't drink. Okay. So we need water for most of our daily course. Here are some ways in which we use water at home. So they have given some ways, okay, in which we use water at home. Okay. Now see the first picture. What does the first picture talks about? Yes, a girl is drinking water. The second picture, children, a man is pouring water to the plant. Third picture, a boy is bathing in bathtub. Okay, next, fourth one. Yes, a Sardar Singh is cooking with water. Okay, so for pouring water to the plant, from bathing, for drinking and for cooking, and even more for all the other daily course, we are using water. Now, can you think of two ways in which we can keep our rivers clean, children? Yes, very good. The very first and foremost thing, we should not throw the garbage into the river. Secondly, yes, very important thing, that we should not wash the cloths in the river. Now, actually, why we want to keep the river clean? As I said before, yes, because it is an important source of fresh water. Tom Meets the Water Babies is an adapted story from the novel The Water Babies, which is written by the author Charles Kingsley. Okay, who are the characters in the story? Tom and Water Babies. Okay, who is this Tom? How he came to meet Water Babies? Tom is actually an ill-treated chimney sweep boy. Okay, he did not meet any kind person so far. And what happened one day? He loses his way and met a kind teacher who gave him food and also a place to sleep in another town. So one night over there, what happened? Tom sleepwalks to a nearby river. Sleepwalks means a person who walks in sleep. So Tom sleepwalks to a nearby river and falls in. So once he falls in, some magic happened to him. He turns into a water baby.
Shh! Come, let's see what happened under the river between Tom and the water baby.
A most wonderful thing happened to Tom. He came upon a water baby, a real live water baby, sitting on the white sand. And when it saw Tom, it looked up for a moment and then cried, "Why, you are not one of us? You are a new baby. Oh, how delightful!" So children, a most wonderful thing happened to Tom. He met a live water baby who was sitting on the white sand. Okay, so when water baby saw Tom for the first time, it looked up for a moment and then asked him, "Why you are not one of us? You are a new baby. Oh, how delightful!" Which means water baby felt very happy, okay, on seeing Tom. And it ran to Tom and Tom ran to it and they hugged each other. So water baby and Tom, they came closer and they hugged each other. At last Tom said, "Oh, where have you been all this while? I have been looking for you for so long and I have been so lonely." So from these words of Tom, we can understand that Tom did not receive this kind of affection so far. So on hearing the question of Tom, water baby is answering, "We have been here for days and days. There are hundreds of us about the rocks. How did you not see us or hear us? We sing every evening before we go home." So water baby is telling to Tom that we are always here only around the rocks, and we are hundreds of them, and we sing every evening before we go home, and I wonder how you were not able to see or hear us. So children, what is sea creature? Sea creature means something which is real or imaginary living things that is found in water bodies. Okay, tell me, what is water body? The body of water ranges from big oceans to sea, river, till tiny ponds and puddle. So these are the water bodies. Tom looked at the baby again and then he said, "Well, this is wonderful. I have seen things just like you again and again, but I thought you were shells or sea creatures. I never thought that you were water babies just like me." So children, Tom looked at the baby again and he felt wonderful because he have seen things just like them again and again, but he thought that they were shells or sea creatures. He never thought that they were water babies just like him. "Now," said the baby, "come and help me, or I shall not have finished before my brothers and sisters come, and it is time to go home." As it is time to go home, water baby is asking for a help from Tom in order to finish its work before brothers and sisters come. In turn, Tom is asking, "What shall I help you with?" A boulder came rolling on this poor dear little rock in the last tomb and rubbed off all its flowers. And now I must plant it again with seaweeds and flowers till I make it the prettiest little rock garden. So children, water baby replied to Tom that a boulder. Boulder means very large rock. So a boulder that came rolling on this poor little rock and dropped off all its flowers in the last storm. And so it is the work of water baby to plant all the flowers and seaweeds. Children, what are seaweeds? Plants that grow in the sea or ocean. Again, till it makes the prettiest little rock garden. So once the boulder rolls on the little rock, it rubbed off all the flowers and seaweeds. So it is whose work to make it the prettiest rock again? It's the work of water baby. Now that's what water baby is telling to Tom. The two worked together, planted flowers and smoothened the sand down round it till it was time to go home. So water baby asked help from Tom and they both started their work around the little rock by planting flowers and smoothing the sand down till they go home. Okay, smoothing the sand. What is smoothing the sand? Making the sand flat and even. Okay. Soon Tom heard all the other water babies coming, laughing, singing and shouting. The noise they made was just like the noise of the ripple. So as they were working, suddenly Tom heard all the other water babies coming, laughing, singing and shouting. The noise made by them was exactly like the noise of the ripple. Children, if you don't know ripple, I have displayed the picture. Can you see? When you throw a stone in the river or ocean or sea, you can see the ripple is formed. Yes? So, he knew that he had been hearing and seeing the water babies all along. Only he did not know them because his eyes and ears were not open. So, Tom is thinking. He thought that he had been hearing and seeing the water babies, but the only thing is he did not knew them as his eyes and ears were not open. And in they came, dozens and dozens of them, some bigger than Tom and some smaller, all in the neatest little white bathing dresses. When they found that he was a new baby, they hugged him and then put him in the middle and danced round him on the sand. There was no one as happy as little Tom. So, as they came, they were dozens and dozens in number. Some are bigger than Tom and some are smaller than Tom. And all were dressed up neatly in little white bathing dresses. When they found that Tom was a new water baby, they hugged him and then put him in the middle and danced round him on the sand in order to show their affection. So there was no one as happy as little Tom at that particular moment. Now then, they cried all at once, "We must come away home, we must come away home, or the tide will leave us dry." So here, all the water babies are telling it's time to go home. If they fail to do so, the tide will leave them dry. You know tide, what is tide? Tide, the waves. Have you seen waves in the sea? Yes, that is called tide. "We have mended all the broken seaweeds." Mended means fixed. So they have fixed all the broken seaweeds and put all the rock pools in order. Rock pool means a small amount of water collected between the rock is called rock pool. So they fixed all the rock pools in order and planted all the shells again in the sand. And nobody will see where the ugly storm swept in last week. So nobody will see the condition. Okay, what was the condition of that rock pool after the storm? "Only where men are dirty and lets yours run into the sea or make a mess upon the clean shore, there the water babies will not come." So where we can't see the water babies, we can't see the water babies in the sources of water which is used by the people. Okay. So they leave the sea anemone and the crabs to clear away everything. Only then the water babies can make a pretty live garden again. And that, I suppose, is the reason why there are no water babies at any watering place which I have ever seen. The sea anemone and crabs are the sea creature. Sea anemone is a soft, brightly colored sea creature that looks like a flower and often lives on rocks under the water. So what is the work of this sea anemone and crabs? Crabs, once it finds its food, it will eat and it will leave the rest of the thing on that particular place. Now, whose work is to clean this sea anemone? It will eat all the tidbits which is left out by the crabs, and also it will clean the tidbits left out in the water. Okay, and that's the reason how the seawater and ocean and river are clean. Okay, so once if people start to utilize the sources of water, what will happen? Since our body is oil and bacteria, that will affect the sea anemone. Since our body is filled with oil and bacteria, that will affect the sea anemone. And that's the reason, okay, we are not able to see the water babies now. Why? Because once the sea anemone and crabs cleans the water only, water babies can make a pretty live garden. So thank you, children. I hope you enjoyed the story. So what's the message that we learned through this story? Yes, very good. We have to keep the water bodies clean.
Okay, children, from this lesson, let us take an oath. Okay? Do you think that it is possible that we can keep the water bodies clean? We all know that the water bodies in different places are dirty now. Yes, right from ocean, sea, river, lake, pond, everything. Do you think it is possible for us to clean? It is not that we want to get inside and clean. We can do one small thing. You know how? Stop throwing the garbage and not letting the wastewater inside the water bodies. If we stop doing these things, we can keep our water bodies clean. And I want you children to follow. And also, you should educate the people around you. So, let's be the change to see the change in the environment. Thank you.